Good morning, friends and fellow traders. This is Doug Campbell with Right Way Options, and this is the morning market prep video for July 13th, 2020. So last week we kind of struggled. A lot of back and forth with a strong close on Friday, but we have, new record infection. So what does that mean for today's open? Well, how about we grab ourselves something to drink, settle in, buckle up, and let's get ready for the Monday edition of the Morning Market Prep video. So this morning, guys, it is just truly remarkable with infection levels reaching new records. Florida reporting over 15,000 cases in one day on Sunday. The market doesn't seem to care. The market seems to be completely and totally focused on the fact that FOMC and Congress will just continue to print as much money as we need to cover all the costs, no matter what happens on the pandemic front. We do have hospitals that are reporting that they are at capacity, but treating COVID patients, but nobody really seems to care. And there is news this morning. It seems they continue to strategically every morning place new news in the market about potential vaccines and the fast tracking this morning of some vaccines to continue to inspire the market higher. So this morning we're looking at a gap up open. We're looking at a substantial gap up open. And let's take a look and see what that means for the market. Obviously last week we were kind of stuck in this little range in here. With that potential of a higher low, but also that potential of a lower high. So kind of in that wedge pattern. This morning, we seem to be resolved to do nothing but buy. And we are gapping up. Futures opened up last night bullish. They continue to stay bullish. And right now, the Dow futures are up 211 points. So what that means at the open, if I zoom this up a little bit, as you can see, the Dow, which has been struggling with its 200-day moving average, we're going to leap above that 200-day moving average at the open. Now, of course, I always have to mention, anytime you get a gap up open, you have to think about the possibility of a pop and drop. We've seen that multiple times here recently, where we get those gap up opens and then sellers come in after that fact. Don't know that that's going to happen today. We'll want to keep an eye on this, but that possibility does exist. So be careful chasing in to the morning open. But technically, we're jumping above that 200-day moving average. There seems to be no concern about impacts of coronavirus. And so we continue to rise here in the market. Notice our 50-day moving average continuing to rise. It's a buy market. There seems to be no price too high that some folks are willing to pay on, particularly tech stocks right now, even ahead of a new season of earnings. So pretty interesting situation as we progress forward. Let's take a look at the SPY this morning. SPY, we have been challenged here by this island reversal that we put in here in early June. And that island reversal has served as a kind of an interesting resistance level. On Friday, we had that big bullish move. Now this morning, we're just going to gap well up into that, reversing that island reversal. So popping up in here, now the question is on this gap up, will we hold it? Any rest or pullback in here obviously sets up good bullish opportunities in this chart and that potential for new record highs coming in the SPY. Notice our 50-day moving average has now crossed up through the 200. We have zero concern about this market. It's all bulls all the time and new records may be on the way. Let's take a look at the NASDAQ. Now the NASDAQ is going to just continue to leap higher. I would suggest that we are very extended here. Notice we're 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 days up with no losing day in those 9 days. And this morning, we're gapping to a new record high in the NASDAQ. So watch that carefully. At any point in time, we could have some profit takers coming in. Right now, though, it just seems, you know, like I say with the big techs, it seems like there is no price too high that investors are willing to pay for these stocks, as that ravenous desire to just buy continues to go on here in the market. So all bulls all the time here in the NASDAQ. There's no hint of a pullback, at least at the moment. Let's take a look at IWM. IWM continues. Has continued to struggle, but this morning we're looking at a gap up open. Let's keep in mind that we have failed this 200-day moving average twice. This morning we're going to gap up here above that little resistance of last week in here, and we'll be pushing up toward that 200-day moving average for another test. One of the big reasons we got a good rally in here is we saw financials pick up pretty nicely on Friday. They're trying to lift up here, so we had a nice little move here in the financials on Friday, pushing higher as we approach those earnings. Remember, JP Morgan will kick off earnings tomorrow, and then we start hitting heavily into those earnings reports, really ramping up over the next couple of weeks on those earnings. So keep an eye on that. It'll be interesting to see how the banks, how they report, considering all of the things that have gone on here recently. Let's keep a close eye on that. Let's take a look at the VIX. The VIX pulled back nicely on Friday, giving us a bearish engulfing candle here on the VIX, still holding above its 200-day moving average. What's been really interesting is as we're setting new record highs, normally we set new record highs and we have the VIX down here in the 10, 11, 12 area when we set new record highs. Well, we're setting new record highs with an elevated VIX, which makes for the wild volatility that we've been seeing lately and the big reversal patterns that we continue to see. Perhaps today that will change and we will finally break that 200-day moving average to the downside here in the VIX. If that does occur, then we can slip back here into some next levels of price support in the VIX. Let's take a look. I've got some lines drawn here. You can see we've got a little price support right in here across these levels. And then that possibility, if we break down through there, we could start slipping down into this level of price support. So let's watch those that carefully if the fear really drops out of this market, which would be really nice for us option traders to get that implied volatility dropping out a little bit. But I wouldn't hold my breath on that. With earnings, we could see that implied volatility remain quite high. Let's take a look at T2122 is the 4-week new high, new low ratio. And you can see this morning we're going to be gapping up, and I suspect with this gap up, we're going to be right back up here. We're going to be up there at that bearish reversal zone. It's all in all the time here on these buyers. Now, whether we can push on through this time and stay up here and not get that selling move that pushes us back down, I don't know, but let's keep an eye on that. We're likely going to be gapping up very near that bearish reversal zone this morning. So keep that in mind as we continue to push and press in this market. Let's take a look at T2101. T2101 is the one thing that's been really giving me a little bit of heartburn here in the market. And that is, we continue to rise, we continue to see the absolute breadth of the market continue to decline. And what that tells me is we have fewer and fewer stocks holding the market higher. We've actually had more decreasing issues than we have advancing issues, and that is a concern as we continue to stretch out some of these big techs. But right now, they have the power to continue to lift the indexes, and they seem certainly willing to do that this morning. This absolute breadth may change today. We may get that to flip over a little bit, actually see a little bit more buying coming in or willingness to buy. So let's watch that carefully. Let's take a look at our economic calendar for today. And our economic calendar does have a few things that we want to think about, not so much today, but for the rest of the week. Today we have just some Fed speakers. And literally, we have a parade of Fed speakers this week. They're just out in force this week. But kind of keep that in mind. We probably won't see any major impacts to price action until tomorrow with the CPI report. We've got industrial production that will come in here on Wednesday as probably the big report and the petroleum status. And then, of course, we have our normal Thursday, but we've added retail sales. That'll be interesting on Thursday. And then housing starts on Friday. So a few things to consider as we move through the week. I think probably the market will be predominantly focused on earnings. Speaking of that, we have about nine companies reporting earnings today, but we really only have one notable this morning, and that's PepsiCo. And PepsiCo is gapping up this morning on its earnings report. Let's keep in mind that in that gap up, we're testing some price resistance levels here in the chart, but PepsiCo has been trying, showing some signs of wanting to move up, gapping up this morning on its earnings report. So any rest, consolidation, or pullback in here sets up an opportunity and a continuation of trend to the upside. So keep an eye on that. PepsiCo looking good this morning, and that's really the only notable that we have this morning in the earnings reports. Keep in mind, tomorrow we will get reports from Citibank. We're going to get reports from Fastenal, reports from WFC and JP Morgan. So we're really going to start moving into third quarter earnings season strongly tomorrow. So kind of keep that in mind as you plan your risk forward. Let's take a look at some stocks that could be setting up for today. But before we do that, if you guys wouldn't mind, if this is the first time you've seen these videos, if you could please do me a favor and click that subscribe button on YouTube, and then also click that bell icon when it pops up so that you'll be notified every time I post one of these videos. You know, the purpose of these videos is not to provide hype. It's not to provide any prediction on direction. It's meant to really take a look at the technicals and the price action of the chart to determine how we might want to approach the market for today. And if you find these videos helpful, please do me a favor and click those thumbs up buttons and leave a brief comment. It helps me out a lot, continues the channel growing, and I thank you guys so very, very much for the support of the effort. Let's take a look at a few stocks. And remember, every time we look at one of these stocks, it's not a recommendation to buy or sell any security. I think it's really, really important that everyone understands you have to do your own due diligence for every trade. You know, the hot tip trade, even from someone that, like myself, has traded for nearly 30 years, is not something that you should be chasing around. You should be looking at those charts very, very carefully and determining whether the trade is right for you. So having said that, let's take a look at some stocks that are looking pretty decent here. Take a look at Cisco. Now, Cisco, I have to let you guys know that I'm a little biased here because I do own this. And Cisco has been hanging out in this little area, and we notice we've kind of broken this little downtrend. We're trying to hold this area in here, and Cisco This morning is looking rather flat. What I'm looking for is that next opportunity to maybe add to this trade if it continues to move on up. Let's keep an eye on Cisco. Potentially could be a good position. We'll want to keep an eye on that. I'm also going to point out stocks like AYX. AYX has been moving up in this beautiful trend, and although we pulled back a little bit on Friday, it's still showing lots of strength in this trend. Beautiful chart. Keep an eye on that. It's looking pretty good. Oracle may be something you want to have on your list. Now, it's made a substantial run here recently. What I like about the chart is this breakout. Let me pull this back a little bit further. We have broken above some significant resistance in the chart. So any kind of bullish move in here, over toward into this trend, we want to watch for that opportunity for that to pop on through and go higher. So keep an eye on that chart's looking pretty good. Take a look at CLX. Clorox continues to show strength, as COVID continues to spread around the country. Their sanitation products that are obviously very, very important. And CLX looking really good, staying very, very strong in this trend. Watch for the next opportunity to enter that. Let's take a look at XLF. Now, XLF had this beautiful little bullish candle on Friday as we popped up in anticipation of some earnings. As we start to approach those earnings, let's keep an eye on XLF. If we can report well, I want to look for that next higher low in here and that opportunity to maybe move with the financials to the upside. Keep in mind that there's rarely ever been any sustained rally in the market without the financials. So if they don't report well, we could see the market sink pretty hard. But if they start reporting well, we'll want to watch in there carefully for that next opportunity. And you could, of course, go to individual banks, taking a look at like Citibank. Citibank had a really great day on Friday, and Goldman Sachs, a really nice day on Friday as well. So we're starting to put in those little higher lows and breaking these downtrends, which give us that potential opportunity for a position in those financials. So watch that closely. Also take a look, there was a big moves, have been big moves in COVID-related stocks, and those stocks that have done really, really well in this market environment. Take a look at eBay continuing to stay really, really strong, looking very, very positive. SQ, very strong. And although we've pulled back just a little bit last week, this continues to set up in this beautiful upside trend. Watch for that next opportunity to get into SQ. PayPal has stayed very strong. We had this little tiny pullback on Friday. Let's watch this for that opportunity, that next leg higher in PayPal, staying very, very strong on the upside. Take a look at IRBT. Now, IRBT kind of failed here. I was watching this resistance level in the chart, and we ran into that resistance and pulled back on Friday. Now, in this market, it doesn't seem like we can sustain any kind of sell-off for very long. So let's watch this closely. If this has that opportunity to turn right back around, stocks have been doing that a lot lately, turn right back around and break back above that support, watch that area up there for that next upside. However, if it continues to fail, watch that failure in here. If we were to take out a level of support and then rally back into resistance, watch for a potential short trade in iRobot. It's been up and up and up, maybe a little bit stretched overall in the market. There may be an opportunity there. Let's keep a close eye on Lowe's. Lowe's has been very, very strong. Notice this nice tight consolidation. Boy, you just about can't get a tighter consolidation in here where the bulls and bears are in agreement with current price. All we need is a little tiny positive move in here. here to continue this trend to the upside. So watch that. It looks like we could be pushing higher this morning. So Lowe's might be one to keep an eye on. It has been quite strong, staying very, very strong. Another one that I am really interested in is energy. In Corona land, we've had demand continuing to fall, apparently, and they say demand is falling even more here just recently. But what's interesting is oil prices are coming up. So, or gas prices are coming up. What I want to watch in here is that possibility of us breaking that downtrend. We break that downtrend and prove to hold hold that downtrend as support. I want to be looking for that next opportunity. Now, I don't know if this is going to occur, but by the way, I just drew out a possible inverted head and shoulders pattern. So keep an eye on energy. It might be one of those places where we can pick up a good price on a stock if we start to move up. Other places we could look, with PepsiCo showing strength today, we might want to look to some of these defensive sector stocks as well. Coca-Cola should get a little bit of a benefit from the PepsiCo earnings this morning. Let's watch this in here. If that can break, here's that downtrend break, this little teeny tiny higher low, nice bullish engulfing candle. There might be that opportunity that this starts its move up. So watch that close for today. So that's all I've got for this morning. I mean, there's plenty of stocks to look at, lots of potential trades out there, but all I have on the list for this morning. If you guys could help me out, and once again, remember to subscribe and click those thumbs up buttons, I appreciate it. You know, with this virus really starting to spread out the way it is in the country, I just want to ask everyone to please be safe, be careful, protect yourself and your family. The ramifications of this, the costs of hospitalization and things are pretty substantial. So stay safe. I want to see you right back here bright and early tomorrow morning. Everyone, take care. Have a great day. I wish you great profits, and we'll talk to you all very, very soon. Have a good one.